Welcome to Everyday Cooking. Today we are going to see 6 upma recipes that you can include in your weight loss diet. The first one is pearl millet or bajra upma. One bowl of this upma is around 220 calories. Now let us see how to do the pearl millet upma. Take 1.5 cups of pearl millet, and this is for 2 persons. We are going to dry roast this until it slightly changes its color. Once it is done, you will get a nice aroma. Here it is done, this has turned crispy. You have to cool it down completely and then transfer it into a mixy jar and powder it. So here the pearl millet flour is ready. To this add a pinch of salt and give a nice mix. Now start adding water little by little and crumble the flour. Finally, it has to be like this. Now we are going to steam cook this flour. Add enough water into your steamer. Here I am using an idli steamer. You can use any kind of steamer. Spread a wet cloth over it. And now you have to spread the flour on the cloth. Close this gently with a wet cloth. Close this and steam cook this for 10 minutes. So here this is ready. For the upma, pour some oil in a pan. To this add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram. Let the mustards pop. Once the mustard starts popping, add few chopped onions and few curry leaves. To this add 2 dry chilies. We are going to saute the onions until it turns translucent. To this add the required amount of salt. And once the onions are translucent, you can add the prepared flour. The flour we have prepared is for 2 persons, so I am going to add 1/2 of it. Give a nice saute. Check for the salt and adjust it according to the need. Give a nice saute for another 2 or 3 minutes and then you can switch off the flame. So here our upma is ready. We are going to have 1 bowl of upma for the breakfast. One bowl of pearl millet upma is around 250 grams and it contains 5.7 grams of proteins, 5 grams of fats, 28.9 grams of carbohydrates and 6.2 grams of fiber. Next is the semolina upma, that is suji upma. The breakfast contains 1 cup of upma, which is around 398 calories and 1 Kerala banana, which will be very small, it is 55 calories. Now let us start doing our diet upma. Take a pan, add around 1/2 cup of semolina, that is suji or rava. Dry roast this until you get the sand consistency, or you can just roast it for about 3 to 4 minutes, that is fine. This is ready, let us transfer this into a plate. Now in the same pan, add about 1 teaspoon of oil. To this add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram. Let the mustards pop. Into this we are going to add few chopped onions. This is 1/4 of an onion. Into this add a small piece of ginger, few curry leaves and 1 green chilli. Saute everything well until the onions turns translucent. Once the onions are done, add a cup of water. To this add the required amount of salt. Once the water starts boiling, you can reduce the flame and add the semolina. Start stirring this. You have to stir this continuously as the semolina will absorb all the water very quickly. Let us close this now and cook for 5 minutes in low flame. So here our upma is ready. Let us transfer this into a serving plate. We are going to have this upma along with a small banana. This is Kerala banana. Now let us have a quick glance on some of the nutrients you have gained through this breakfast. Our upma has approximately 10 grams of proteins, 15 grams of fat, 57 grams of carbohydrates and 6 grams of fiber. And a small banana has 0.6 grams of protein, 0.1 gram of fat, 13 grams of carbohydrates and 0.8 grams of fiber. Next we are going to see poha or flattened rice upma. One bowl that is around 230 grams has 354 calories. Now let us move on to the recipe. Take a pan, pour some oil in it. To this add a quarter cup of onion, one green chili, one medium-sized chopped carrot and a quarter cup of green peas. Let us saute this for a few minutes. Add the required amount of salt. Now we are going to add a little water and we are going to cook this until the vegetables are cooked well. Close this and cook for a few minutes. If you close it, the vegetables will get cooked quickly. By the time, let us wet the flattened rice. Take a sieve like this and add 2 cups of flattened rice. Add enough water and wet it nicely. This is simply like cleaning. You should not soak the flattened rice. You have to clean it in order to get it wet. Now drain the water and keep the flattened rice aside. Moving on to the vegetables, it is perfect now. It got cooked well. Once the vegetables are done, we can add the flattened rice. Give everything a nice mix. Keep it in medium flame and cook this for another 3 to 4 minutes. Taste for the salt. If it required, adjust the salt now. Finally, add few chopped coriander leaves. So here the poha, aval or flattened rice upma is ready. Each bowl of flattened rice upma is around 230 grams and it contains 6.5 grams of proteins, 11.1 grams of fats, 57 grams of carbohydrates and 3.6 grams of fiber. Our next recipe is going to be ragi or finger millet semia. For the recipe, take enough water in a bowl. To this, add the required amount of salt. Let the salt dissolve completely. Now add the ragi or finger millet semia. This is around 3 cups. You cannot cook ragi semia as the regular one. That is, you cannot add this into the boiling water and cook it like the regular semia. You need to steam cook this separately and before steam cooking, you have to soak this in salt water. Leave this for just 2 minutes, not more than that. If you soak this for more than 2 minutes, this will get dissolved in the water. Now drain the water and transfer this into a plate. I'm transferring this into a steamer plate. Let us steam cook this for 10 minutes. This is after 10 minutes, this has become soft. Now let us move on to the tempering. Add some oil in a pan. To this add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram and 1/2 teaspoon of split chickpeas. Let the mustards pop. Once the mustard starts popping, add 1/4 cup of chopped onions, 2 green chilies and few curry leaves. Saute everything well. You have to saute this until the onions gets translucent. To this add the required amount of salt. So here the onions are done. Let us add the cooked semiya. Give everything a nice mix and cook this for another 2 to 3 minutes. So here our ragi semiya or the finger millet semiya is ready. If you are following any diet, this will be a perfect recipe. You can always use ragi recipes for the diet. Finger millet is rich in fiber, calcium and iron. One bowl of ragi semiya is around 100 grams and it contains 357 calories. This has 10 grams of proteins, 0.4 grams of fats, 75.2 grams of carbohydrates and 3.3 grams of fiber. Next, let us see how to do finger millet or ragi upma with ragi flour. This is going to be around 344 calories. We are going to take one bowl of upma and one egg. Let us move on and see how to prepare finger millet upma or ragi upma. For this, we need a cup of ragi flour, that is finger millet flour. Add the required amount of salt. Start sprinkling water little by little and give a nice mix. You are going to crumble the flour. Finally, it has to be like this. If you take some and press it, you'll be able to shape it. And if you crumble it, it should also get crumbled. This is the right consistency. Now take a pan and pour some oil in it. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram and 1/2 teaspoon of split chickpeas. Once the mustard starts popping, you can add few curry leaves and around 10 chopped shallots or 1/2 onion. Let the shallots turn translucent. To this, let us add 2 dry chilies and give everything a nice saute. Once the onions are translucent, we can add the prepared ragi flour. We are going to saute this until it becomes non-sticky and fully cooked. You can see that all the moisture has gone. Let us close this and cook for a few more minutes. So here our ragi upma is ready. What we need is a bowl of ragi upma. And we are going to have one egg along with this. One bowl of finger millet upma has 5.1 grams of proteins, 8.7 grams of fats, 46.9 grams of carbohydrates and 8.2 grams of fiber. One boiled egg has 4.8 grams of protein, 0.4 grams of fats, 4 grams of carbohydrates and it doesn't have any fiber. The next is going to be oats upma. The approximate calorie of our breakfast is 375. So now let us start preparing our breakfast. The first is oats upma. For the upma, add 3/4 cup of oats in a pan. Now we are going to dry roast this for another 2 or 3 minutes. Once you get a nice aroma, you can switch off the flame. Now take a pan, pour some oil in it. To this add 1/2 cup of chopped onions and 1 green chilli and give this a nice saute until the onions turns translucent. Once the onions are done, add 1/4 cup of chopped beans, 1/4 cup of chopped carrot and 1/4 cup of green peas. Now give this a nice saute. To this add few curry leaves and the required amount of salt. To this, let us add around half a cup of water for the vegetables to get cooked. Close this and cook in medium flame until the water gets evaporates. So here you can see that there is no water and the vegetables has also turned soft. Now let us add the roasted oats. To this, let us add half a cup of water. Now let us close this and cook for a few minutes. So here the upma is done. It has to be like this. Oats upma is ready. Next, let us move on and do our scrambled eggs. Take a pan, pour some oil in it and crack open one egg. To this, add some pepper powder and the required amount of salt and start scrambling the egg. So here our egg is ready. For the breakfast, we are going to have one bowl of oats upma. And one scrambled egg. One bowl of upma is around 230 grams and it contains 7.8 grams of proteins, 13 grams of fats, 30 grams of carbohydrates and 7.2 grams of fiber. A scrambled egg has 7 grams of proteins, 7.8 grams of fats, 1.5 grams of carbohydrates with no fiber. Hope the recipes were useful. We'll join you in another interesting recipe and don't forget to subscribe our channel.